Hey everybody, today we are going to solve each question of quiz 6. Okay, for the first question, let's read it. Write E for even number and O for odd number. It's about just 2 points. Everybody, we have some numbers to find even number or odd number. So, as you know, we have rule. So, it's about how can we understand your number is even or odd. Okay, now let's see this. Okay, the first one is even numbers. So, even numbers. Your number, if your number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, so we call your number is even. So as you know, we have odd numbers rules. That is, if the last digit of the number is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, we call this kind of number odd number. Okay, now let's look at turn back to question. The first one is 45. Everybody, 45 ends with 5. As you can see, 5 goes odd number. So because of that, we call 45 is odd number. Okay, now let's look at 68. 68 ends with 8. As you know, as you have learned, so 8 is even number. Because of that, we write there A. What about 123? It's not important. Your number has more digit. So why? Because we look at the just last digit, that is 3. 3 is odd number. Because of that, we write in this space odd. Then last one is 490. 490 ends with 0. So as you know, 0 is even number. Because of that, we just write A. Okay, so we have finished the first one. Now let's look at the question 2. Write down whether the result is an even or odd number. It's about, again, just 2 points. Everybody, if you want to add 2 even number, as you can see, 68 and 24, your result has to be even. Okay, now let's look at another one, that is subtraction. The first one is about odd number, the second one is about even number. So we have rule also, if you want to subtract even number then odd number, your result has to be odd. Okay, the next one is about multiplication. If you want to multiply 2 even numbers, so your result has to be even. The last one is about addition, but the first one is odd number, the second one is odd number. If you want to add 2 odd numbers, so your result has to be even. Okay, now let's look at the question 3. The question 3 says, fill in the table below, write just yes or no. It's about 8 points. So, we have numbers 170 and 6543. Okay, now let's look at the first divisible by 2. Okay, now let's remember divisible by 2. If your number is even, your number is divisible by 2. If your number is odd, your number is not divisible by 2. Okay, first of all, 170 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes. Why we say yes? Because your last digit is 0. So 0 goes to even number. Because of that, we say 170 is divisible by 2. Now let's put yes. Okay, what about 170 is divisible by 3 or not? We have a rule about divisible by 3. If the sum of the each digit of the number is multiple of 3, your number is divisible by 3. Okay, sum of digit means you add each digit of the number. 1 plus 7 is equal to 8. 8 is not multiple of 3. Because of that, we write in this space no. Okay, now let's remember divisible by 5. So we have rule to understand your number is divisible by 5 or not. So just you look at last digit of the number. If your last digit of the number 5 or 0, your number is divisible by 5. So what's your last digit of the number? That is 0. So because of that, we write in this space yes. What about just one thing is that is about divisible by 10? So it's the easiest one. So you look at just your last digit of the number. If your last digit of the number is 0, just 0, your number is divisible by 10. We write yes. What about next one? Another number that is 6543. Okay. So is this number divisible by 2 or not? So we look at just even or odd. Your number ends with 3. So 3 is not even number. Because of that, we write here no. Another one, divisible by 3. Is this number divisible by 3 or not? So how can we understand? We add each digit of this number. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 4, 11 plus 4, 15. 15 plus 3 is equal to 18. 18 is multiple of 3. Because of that, we write here yes. What about divisible by 5? So you look at just last digit of the number. So your last digit of the number is 3. So is different than 0 or 5. Because of that, we write here no. The one thing is left that is divisible by 10. So it's about your last digit must be just 0, but your last digit is not 0. Because of that, we write there no. Okay, now let's look at the question 4. Find the GCF of 24 and 30. First of all, what is GCF? GCF means greatest common factor. Okay, so in this kind of question to solve, so first of all, you will start from the back, from the last. So I mean, you find the factor. How can we find the factor of these numbers 24 and 30? Okay, now let's look at the 24 to find each factor of them. First of all, how can you get 24? We have some numbers to multiply to get 24. Okay, now let's write them. Okay, as you can see here, 1 times 24, 24, 2 times 12, 24, 3 times 8, 24, and 4 times 6, 24. Okay, now let's write the factors, each factor of 30. Okay, so how can we get it? Okay, now let's see. 1 times 30, 2 times 15, 3 times 10, and 5 times 6. Okay, so we have finished to find the factor, each factor of 24 and 30. Okay, now let's find the common. So common means in math we use common as same. Okay, now let's find the which numbers are the same. Everybody, so now let's choose this one. Okay, is one same? Yes, we have one and one. Two? Yes, we have two and here two. Three, what about three? Is three same? Yes. Okay, four, is there any four here in this part? No. Okay, now let's start. From here, 6. Okay, do you have 6 in this part? Yes, 6 and 6. 8, no. 12, no. And 24, no. That's enough. Okay, now let's write the common factors. Everybody, so common factors are 1, 2, 3, and 6 are the common factors. So, just one thing is left, G. G shows you greatest one. So, greatest. 1, 2, 3, and 6. So, which number is the greatest here among these numbers? So, just one thing is left to find. This is the easiest one, that is 6. Easy, right? Okay, now let's continue to solve the question. Okay, question 5. Everybody find LCM of 6 and 8. As you know, LCM. So, each letter shows you something. L, list. C, common. M, multiple. Okay, first of all, again in these kinds of questions, so we start to solve from the last, M. M shows you multiples. Okay, first of all, let's find the multiples of 6. Everybody, so if you want to find the first multiple of 6, you have to multiply by 1. Multiplication table, so helps you to find all multiples of the number. Okay, first 6 times 1, second 6 times 2, next 6 times 3. Okay, now let's see. Okay. 6 times 4, 6 times 5, 36 times 6, 36, something like that. Okay, now let's find the multiples of 8. So, if you want to find the first multiple of 8, you have to multiply by 1. Okay, 8 by 1 is equal to 8, 8 by 2 is equal to 16, 8 by 3 is equal to 24. Okay, now let's write each multiples of 8 here. Okay, so we have find the multiples of each number, that is 6 and 8. Okay, now let's find the common multiples, means same numbers of them. For example, 8 same? No. 16? No. 24? Yes. We have 24, we have 24. Okay, 32? No. 40? No. 48? Yes. We have 48 and 48. 56? No. 64? No. Okay, so what numbers are the same? What numbers are the common? Okay, now let's write this one. 24 and 48 are the common multiples. Okay, just one thing is left, that is the easiest one, least. 24 and 48, so which number is the least, smallest, lowest number, that is 24. Okay, now let's look at another question, that is 6. Is 45 a multiple of 5 or not? Explain why. Okay, first of all, so how can we solve in this kind of question? 45 multiple of 5. Okay, we have to say something, so now let's say that is yes. Okay, why yes? I wanna know it. So you know this question, so or how much you know in this kind of question. So what's your ability to solve the question? Everybody, first of all, let's look at this one. Yes, because we have number. We have number to multiply by 5. That is 9 by 9. Sorry, 5 by 9 is equal to 45. So because of that, we say yes. What about next question, that is 7? Is for a factor of 30. Explain why. Why? So first of all, I want to show you the answer is must be no. Why? Because there is no number. Everybody, because there is no number to get 30 by 4. As you know, for example, 4 times 7 is equal to 28. 4 times 8 is equal to 32. So 30 is between them. 30 is between 28 and 32. Because of that, there is no number. We cannot find anymore. Everybody, thank you for listening to me. So have a good day.